Hey guys, Michelle Glass here. Our job for today is to look at this model of the spinal cord. It's a pretty big, so we're gonna look at it from the side view. Now, as you're looking at this model, you'll see not just spinal cord structures, you can also see some muscles and of course spinal nerves. And so we're gonna be naming all those things. So let's start with the muscles. We can pick out, cut here and here, sternocleidomastoid muscles. We can see here the internal intercostal and external intercostals. And notice the division there so that you can see this is two different muscles, one superficial and one deep. Moving down, we can see on one side of our model our psoas major. Remember that's spelled with a silent P. And then our iliacus muscle here and here. Okay, let's focus in on the spinal cord. So our spinal cord is this structure here. The spinal cord is surrounded on the outside, very outermost layer, by the dura mater. It's our outermost meningeal layer. It's represented here in white. So you can see that white line. It's especially showing up here, coming around, okay? On the front side of the spinal cord, we have a depression, which is called the anterior median fissure. We have two enlarged areas. We have a cervical enlargement here and lumbar enlargement here. And then we can see where our spinal cord is coming to an end. It's here between the L1 and the L2 vertebrae. Position the camera a little bit. That is called the conus medullaris. Coming off of the conus medullaris, you have a ligament connecting the conus medullaris to the coccyx, and that's called the phylum terminale. And also in this area here, you can see the bundle of spinal nerves called the cauda equina. To finish things up, let's take a look at the spinal nerves that are visible here. So let me position it in this direction. We're going to start by picking out the femoral nerve, which you can see on both sides, lateral femoral cutaneous, then the genitofemoral, which is sitting on top of the psoas major. It's pretty much been dissected off of this side, so I would just test it on this side here. Then we can see iliohypogastric and ilioinguinal, which is the more medial of these two, iliohypogastric, ilioinguinal. And then you can see obturator nerve here and here. And you can also see on this model how large the sciatic nerve is compared to these others. And that's it.